yesterday we have completed planning dimensions both in currency application and non-currency application. Before starting this, let us start the remaining services. I think we have to start our Apache server, our MI registry and planning, because I have started all other SBase related content. So now let us log into our currency application only. From today onwards, let's look into currency application only. So this is my currency application. Okay. So yesterday we have discussed about all this dimensions. All the dimensions that we are having: accounts, currency, entity, period, scenario, version, year, and also we have discussed from SBase point of view, right? So from SBase point of view also we have discussed. Let us start this application also. Okay. Now, having this, I want to create a web form. So to create web forms in your planning application, based on this, I want to create an Excel type of form, but it should be web-based form. So that I can create from administrator, and in this I select manage data forms. I'm going to select this manage data forms. Once I select this particular screen comes up. In this screen, I'm able to see create, and I'm able to see the create. Two creates are available. This create is used to create folder structure. So forms is a folder under which you want a folder for actuals. Let us think. Actual. So now if you expand this, you will be able to see. So this create is meant for your folders. Okay. This assign access is in place from 11 version only. Before in 9.3.1, we never used to have this assign access. Okay. So now, in actuals, if I want to create a web form, I'll select this actuals folder and now I'll select create. When I say create, at the start of the application itself, it will ask which database has to be, on which database you want to create this particular web form. If say I want to create it on revenue, I can select revenue, or if I want, I want to create it on expense. But you cannot create a web form based on two databases. You cannot create a web form at a time depending upon two databases. I can create a web form based out of only expense, or I can create a web form based out of only revenue. Either I can create on expense or on revenue, not on both. So let us select expense first. Why I'm selecting expense means because most of the accounts source plan type is expense. For maximum accounts, the source plan type is expense database. So I'll select expense. And I'm giving a name called as actuals. Actuals for FY12. Let us say actuals for FY12. My form name is actuals for FY12. I'll say row column layout. When I select row column layout, it is asking about columns related information and rows related information. A web-based form means whatever Excel sheet you take, Excel sheet lo what you'll be having, you'll be having rows and columns. So now in columns, what dimensions you want? Say from columns, I want my period dimensions. So what all periods you want, you can type them. If you are not knowing which members are there, you can select this option. You can select this particular option. It will display your members in it. When I expand this, I'll be able to see all my members. But from this, I want all level 0 members of your year total. Then I can say quarter 1, quarter 2, quarter 3, and quarter 4. I've selected this and I'll say descendants of. I don't want quarter 1, 2, 3, 4. I'll say descendants of. take them to my right hand side. Descendants of quarter 1, descendants of quarter 2, quarter 3, quarter 4, and I say sum. That is written into your figure. If you want, you can consider another dimension, or if you want one more dimension in your columns, then also you can say add dimension. Three dimensions or four dimensions or five dimensions you can add. But make sure that at least one dimension is present in your column. There should be at least one dimension in your column. Now coming to rows. From rows, I want to select my accounts. I'll select my accounts, and in accounts, I'll say I want all these accounts. And select members and send them to my right hand side and say sum. Now I also want entities in my rows. So instead of having entities in rows, I'll go to the next option called as page and pointer. So in page, if you want, you can select, otherwise you can leave this. Say I want an entity and I also want a currency and I also want a year. I also want an extra dimension called as, say sorry, currency I wanted, entity I wanted, I also wanted year, and I also wanted a version. Why I am selecting version means I want to check if I am able to input numbers on parent. Okay, now coming to scenario, point of view. In point of view, you can select only one member, but out of your pages or rows or columns, you can have multiple members. Say from currency, I'm having local and USD. Both the members I'm selecting. Submit. From entities, I'm selecting all the entities. I'll take them to my right hand side. And from years, because it is actual reporting, I'll select only year into consideration. Also, submit. From version, I'll take both the version, bottom up version and target version. All these members yesterday we have created, right? Also, submit. But from scenario, you can select only one scenario from this particular point of view. Focus of your total web form is on your actuals only, right? So I can have only one member in my point of view. Say I selected actuals. And if I try to put budget also, it says only you cannot select more than one member. So point of view can carry only one member. I'll say submit. I'm not going into another tabs. So in this rows and columns, you should have at least one dimension. In page, if you want, you can keep dimensions. Otherwise, you can completely remove dimensions from your page. And you can have a point of view. At least there should be one dimension in your point of view also. Okay. Now, other options, business rules. Preview is the last tab, how your web form looks like. This is how your web form is going to look like. Now, I'll save this. I'll close this. So, this is how I have created my web form. But if I open it from here, it will be opening in your editable mode. But I want to open it and input numbers into this particular workbook. For doing that, if you see, folders are available here. Under that, form, expand, actuals you expand. Now you are able to see your web form. When I click on this, it will open my web form. This is how your web form is going to look now. So, I am selecting local and I am selecting India. But it is opened only for July. Why it is open only for July? Any idea? Because yesterday we have set your dimension scenario actual period opened only for month. Edit. We have opened only July month. So for that only it is displaying only July. If I set this to December, let us say set it to December and let it save. Now if I open my web form, it will open all for all this month. The months are need to open it. So on scenario, you can restrict what months to be opened and what months to be closed. Now you are clear, right? Arthamainadi ippudu, based on your dimension, and in that dimension based on your scenario, your web forms will be locked. So you want to log this back, say edit, say if I put July, only your July month will be open. FY12, July, only that month will be open. And if I want to open till December, I have to change this. And if I want to open it till 15 or 18 years, I can just select my end year as 18. The option select chesthe, accordingly your web form will be open. Now July is only open. Let us save it and open your web form. Only July will be open. Okay. Now let us think that we have data opened for Jan, Feb, March. Okay, Jan, Feb, March open. Let us think that way. Go to dimensions. Open the scenario for Jan, Feb, and March. So how will we open it? Actuals, edit. So start year, start month should be January, and end month should be your March. And so now if I open this, only Jan, Feb, March is it. So page, this is currency, entity, year, BUI version. Okay, now let us look into your year. Almost it is only 1 year. I can even have this in my point of view. My point of view is having only actuals which cannot be edited. This cannot be edited. Now, in case if I select USD, what happens? Let us see. I'll select USD and I'll say put. This particular cell cannot be edited. Only this data is to be calculated data. It cannot be inputted by you. ఈ డేటా ఎప్పుడు వస్తుందంటే ఆఫ్టర్ గెటింగ్ యువర్ కరెన్సీ కన్వర్టెడ్ దిస్ డేటా విల్ బి దిస్ సే ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఇఫ్ ఐ సెలెక్ట్ యుఎస్ అండ్ ఇఫ్ ఐ సే గో ఈవెన్ ఫర్ దిస్ డేటా హ్యాస్ టు బి కన్వర్టెడ్ మీన్స్ యూ కెన్ ఇన్పుట్ యువర్ డేటా ఓన్లీ ఇన్ లోకల్ ఓన్లీ లోకల్ కెన్ బి ఇన్పుటెడ్ యుఎస్డి కెనాట్ బి ఇన్పుటెడ్ యువర్ రిపోర్టింగ్ కరెన్సీ కెనాట్ బి inputted. They are always converted data, calculated data will be displayed, right? Now, let us include account also in this. So, to include account also in this, sorry, go to your data forms, make some changes, edit this form. Now, if you see, after setting your plan type, in future you cannot change this plan type. Once you have set this plan type, it cannot be changed even if you edit. If you want to create a new platform for revenue, you cannot edit this and you cannot save as, do a save as. Compulsorily, you have to create a new one because to change your database type. Okay. Now, going to rows column layout. Yeah, rows column layout, page point of view. I'll remove this year from here. And I'll add FY12 into this. Right? Making some corrections. Okay? After this, I'll go to those columns. I also wanted accounts. Account. Okay, I've selected account also. And I'll say I descendants of. Everywhere, I'll select I descendants of. Including descendants of year total. I'll say now let us open this particular version. Now if you see for bottom up version, you cannot input on your account because it is a level 1 member. But if I select target version, if I say go, I'll be able to input numbers on my account. Now you are familiar about your version dimension. Familiar about version dimension, familiar about your scenario dimension. Now if you see in this particular part, you are not able to see account 02 because this is not available in your database, expense database, because it is a revenue account. Okay, now I am inputting some data, 1000, 100, 200, 300. This is the data that I have inputted. Now I want to send this data into my SQL database. Means I want to save this data in this web form. To save this, you can just click on this save button. When you say save, this database is locked and sent indirectly into your SQL database. though it is displaying as if it is present in your waveform, but this data will be present in your SVH database. Then only it can be displayed. Okay? Right. After doing this, now I want to see the converted data. The data is not getting converted. Means you have to perform some extra activities for this data to be converted to USD format. So local for US it is 100, and say for India you don't have any data. Let me input some data into this. 100, 200, 300, and same as I'll update for Canada also. I'll update 100, 200, 300. That's it. Save. And I'll update for Europe also. 100, 200, 300. I'll save this. So each and every entity is having data. UK will also have that data. Let us input that data. So this is the data present in each and every entity. So now I want to convert data that is present in local to USD from India point of view, from US point of view, from UK point of view, from Europe point of view, and even Canada point of view. So for that, what I have to do is go to administrator. Before that, I have to create my exchange rates. At what rate your data has to be converted, that we are going to define. So select manage exchange rates. After selecting this, create a table, your exchange rate table. So this particular rate table is being created for actuals. So I'll say actuals, and here is FY1. I'll say this table got created. Now I'll edit this table. When I say edit, if you see, it is asking for average option, ending option. You know, exchange rate table. In accounts dimension, you have seen exchange rate table option, average, ending, historical, beginning balance. These options are there. The same options are available. Because most of our accounts are average and ending, we are not going to consider beginning balance or historical. I am unchecking these options. But what is this method? When I say next, if you see method, it is nothing but you are getting an option called as multiply or divided by. If I uncheck this, even this method, you will not get this method option. Whether you want to multiply or divided by, that option will not be given. If you want that option, what I have to do? I have to check this option. After checking this, now if you see, your exchange rate table is open for year FY08, 09, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, whatever years you have. But in this, I want to input it only for year FY12. I have selected this FY12. And your reporting currencies, only one reporting currency is there, so I have selected USD. Now, Canada, Canadian dollar, almost it will be approximately equal to your US dollar. Say it is something 1.01 times. Your average value is 1.1 times and your ending value is 1.02 times. So the same thing has to be inputted for February, March, April till my December. This rate is not going to change throughout the year. So how to input it? Either I can copy this, I can go and paste into each and every cell, or I can right click on this and I can say fill year. When I say fill year, it starts filling this entire year. But if I say fill table, it will fill each and every year. How many years are present, all those years will be filled with this value. This is about your fill year and fill table, right? Now let me fill this. For Canada, I am multiplying this, and for Europe, so approximately it will be 1.2 times, or it will be equals to 1.23 times, something around that. 1.23, and it is also equals to 1.24 ending values. So I'll say fill year. Yes, exchange rate information, users will be providing you that information. And GBP. So GBP is greater than your euro, let us make it as 1.3 4 times, and let us make it as 1. These are all assumed values, they are not perfect, don't bother about that. So I'll say fill table 4, and I'll say fill year. Fill year only after. But India, it has to be divided by 55 rupees, right? And ending it became, let us think it became 56 rupees. Fill year. So this way we have filled our year related information for FY12. Now I'll say save. When I say save, this particular information is not saved into your SBase database, but it is saved into your relational database. All your exchange rate related information is stored into relational database. If I want to load this data into SBase database, so e data name, if I want to load into my SBase database, I have to go to dimensions, and in dimensions select your scenario, select your actuals, edit it, and you have to tag your exchange rate. Because for actuals itself we are converting data, so select this actuals FY12 and save it. Okay, now your exchange rates are tagged with your actuals, but still they are not sent to your FBase database. If they have to be sent to your FBase database, you have to go to your manage database and do a database refresh. Until and unless if you don't do any database refresh, your exchange rates will not be populated into your FBase database. I'll say refresh. So I'll say refresh. Now when I say refresh, if you can see in between populating exchange rates, such option will pop up. Populating financial exchange rates. It will finish very fast. So now your exchange rates are logged and sent into the FBase. But conversion calculation script should be written. For that, I'll say manage currency conversion. When I say manage currency conversion, if you come to your SBase database and if you like refresh your database list or calculation script list, you're not able to see any calculation scripts right now. But from here, I can automatically create a calculation script from manage currency conversions. When I say manage currency conversion, it is asking for a name, it is actual, and say next. So what currency it has to be converted? Only one currency is the reporting currency, so it has to be converted to USD currency. And what scenario you are doing it? I'm doing it on my actuals, and but you are inputting numbers on target version, not on bottom up version, because we have selected in waveform as target version. So I selected target, and I'll say in target version there is only one member, I will select target. When I say save, automatically two calculation scripts will be created into your SBase database when I say save. So these conversion scripts have been saved. Now come back to your SBase database, right click on this and say refresh calculation scripts. Now you are able to see calculation scripts part, you are able to see something called as actuals, and also you are able to see something called as HSP create. This is nothing but target version. If you see B, it is nothing but bottom up version. At the last, you are able to see capital T, it is nothing but target version. If there is B, it is nothing but bottom up version. Now if you go into this calculation script, so this is your calculation script. So if you try to understand this calculation script, it is more than enough. So you know what this fix is, you know how to read this, you know ease member, we have discussed about this ease member, we have discussed about ease UDA, and also we have discussed about your level 0 members. Right now in this there is no such level 0 members right now, but whenever there is another calculation script, in that calculation script you will be getting ease level 0 members. In this we have considered only January, February, March, so it is displaying January, February, March. Otherwise it would have displayed time period at level members of time periods, comma 0, it will be displayed. Means it will be considering January, February till December. Okay. So it has created this calculation script. Try to understand this calculation script. This is one more calculation script. So remove these level member of accounts. Out of this, it is removing HSP average, HSP ending, HSP historical. Now you are familiar about remove level members, you know what list is. So all functions you are familiar about, right? So try to understand this calculation steps. Come with this calculation steps maybe tomorrow. But right now, after creating this calculation steps, what I'm going to do is I'm opening my webform again back. Okay, let us check if this data has been converted to USD. So still the data has not been converted. For this data to be converted, at least one time you have to run your calculation step. Run this calculation step, right click on this and say execute. That's it. Okay. This has been completed, now execute this calculation step. That's it. Okay. Both calculation steps are executed, but for your web form also there will be, by default there will be two calculation steps which get created automatically. So one is currency and another one is data form. So run this currency script. After that, run this data form. After running this, just go to IF local, edit any one member, say make it as 300 and say save. Now come to USD and say go. Now you see your values have been converted. Let us look into local of India. Row 100, 200, 300, 600. Let us look into USD how they are converted. So, it is not converted. Let us say local. Okay. Change this value. So, because they might have been freeze, for that reason, it is not. Save it. So, let us make it to USD. Has to convert. When this is getting converted, local of Canada, USD of Canada, USD is not getting converted. Let me see it. Currency conversion for. Bottom of question. USD scenario actual version. So now if you see there will be another two steps will be created. So one is for your bottom up and one is for your left. Let us run this. Execute. Okay. Execute. Okay. Okay, even this number for now. The numbers are different. So it is nothing but $1.8, $5, $5.4, and whole it is nothing but $12.7. So this is how your data gets converted. But in this, if I input on my account 06, this data will not be converted. You know why? And say save, and I'll go to my technical instance, update this number. Save it and let us check in USD. You now see refresh. So if you see this data is getting converted, but here account 06 data is not getting converted. Why is that? Because it is a saved assumption. saved assumption data will not be converted, only your expense, revenue, assets, liabilities, equities data will be converted. Your saved assumption data will not be converted. So whenever you update your numbers, after updating your numbers, make a practice that, say I am updating this number. So after updating this, save it, parallelly run this calculation script, first currency script, then your data form script. After doing this, go to your USD and check. Now this data gets. So user is not happy running this particular calculation. It's two calculations. They have to run automatically. So what I can do is, I can go to data forms, open this existing form, edit, go to business rules tab, and in this business rules tab, select your appropriate calculation steps. These are the two calculation steps which have to run automatically. Bottom, you are able to see properties, and in this, you can say run on load. Whenever you are opening this web form, this calculation script starts running, or you can select run on load. Now, say for example, if I am updating number into this local 200. Now, when I say save, this data gets saved automatically. Your rule was run successfully. Both the rules will also run automatically, so that user need not run them every time. So this is how you can create your conversions. Okay, this is a symmetric form. Now let us look into asymmetric web form, and at the same time let us also look into composite web forms. So what are these asymmetric web forms? So nothing but, if you see in this particular web form, always it is pulling only January, February, March related information. Say for example, if I want to pull for account 01 only January data, for account 03 I want to pull February data, for account 04 I want to pull only March data. So how can I create this particular data form? So let us go to manage data forms. In this particular folder itself, let us try to create a data form. So this is nothing but, let us say first it is symmetric, asymmetric web form. So in this, what I want accounts, I also want time period with them. In accounts, what all accounts I want? I want account 1, 3, 4 accounts I need in this. And at the same time, from period I want January, February and March. Let us think, this is the requirement. January, February, March, I'll send it to right hand side. Let's say sum. So with account 1 I want January, with account 3 I want February, with account 4 I want March. Okay. Now let us go to entities. I want all these entities. I'll say submit. And I also want your currency. Both local currencies and USD currencies. Clear? From page and point of view, I don't want anything in my page and point of view. I want only scenario called as actuals. From version, I want only target version. And from year, I want only FY. I'm not selecting anything from my page dimension. This can be done like this also. I'll say save. Now this web form is created. But if I open this web form, it is pulling symmetrical columns. For account 01, it is pulling January, February, March. 3, it is pulling January, February, March. 4, it is pulling January, February, March. Same as for India, it is pulling local USD. For US, it is pulling local USD. Canada, it is pulling local USD. Europe, it is pulling local USD. UK. But my requirement is, for account 01, I want only January. Account 03, I want only February. Account 04, I want only March. Then in this scenario, how can you create your data? So for that, what I'll do is, I'll go back to administrator, data forms, select my actuals and select this, and I will say edit. Okay. Now I will go into my rows and columns. What I will do is, I will remove this January, February, and I will also remove this extra accounts. After removing this, I'll say add a column. I'm not adding dimension, but I'm adding only column. What account I want? I want account 03. I want account 03 in which which should be opening for February. I'll say submit. I'll add another column in which I'll be having account 04 and in which I'll be having March information. I'll say submit. Okay. If I say edit columns, now I'll be able to see account 01 is January, account 03 is February, account 04 is March. Return to data form layout. I'll just do a save as. I'll not save it. I'll give asymmetrical reference. Now this webform is created. Now let us open this particular asymmetrical webform. Now if I open this, if you see account 01 January is only opening, account 03 only February is opening, account 04 March is only opening. But now what user is saying is user want to lock only February related information. He want to lock February, make this particular column as a read only. No user should input information in this cells. And he should be opening March and January. Very peculiar reason. If you block on scenario, you can block from January to March. But you cannot lock January and March. Right? Scenario means you cannot lock January and you cannot lock March. You can lock January, February, March. But now I want to lock only February. So how can you lock this particular webform? In formula, how can you lock this particular cell? Go to manage data forms. Open this particular web form, your asymmetrical web form, edit it. Now in this, I'm going into my row column layout. I'll say edit columns and I'll say I want to lock February related information. I'll say edit. When I say edit, this particular column is open. But you see below this, you can make it as a read only. These days they are asking many questions about this. I have four columns. I want to make two columns read only. Okay, from scenario I'm not blocking it. When I say save, okay. Now if I open this, if you see February is clear, I can block this particular column. If you want to open it, what you have to do? Edit it and make that or uncheck that particular read only. Based on this, there will be compulsory question will be there. Say I'm having four columns. In this four columns, I want to make first column as a read. The first column as right and last column as right. Middle in between two columns should be in read only mode. Can we do that in a web form? So that can be done with help of asymmetric web forms. And the same way, what is the difference between symmetric and asymmetric? In symmetric, you will be pulling columns equally for each and every member. In asymmetric, you will be pulling columns asymmetrically with each and every member. So now I want to create a composite. So to create a composite form, I'll just go into manage data forms. Now I want to see both these symmetric and asymmetric forms in one form. Then I can say create composite form. When I say create composite form, it will ask for a form name versus. When I select rows and columns, it will display all available web forms. So I want this asymmetric and I want this symmetric and take them to one reference. If you want, you can have common combined POV or combined pages. So let us see this difference later. What are the business rules that you can attach to this? These are the business rules which are attached to your reference. These are the business rules which are already attached. And now if I go to properties, I cannot change these options. For that response, whatever options you have selected, those forms will be automatic. Those options will be automatically displayed. You cannot do anything to this. So now if I open this particular web form, you can see both the web forms in a single page. You can see your symmetrical web form and you can also see your asymmetrical. You can create this web forms. Even if, say for example, this is connected to your revenue database and this is connected to your expense database, you can have them in a single database. But let us see what is the combined POV and combined wages. Select this, edit this, roles, and say combined POV, combined wages. When I say save, and when I say open this particular web form, if you see, your page is combined and your point of view is also combined. You can have a combined page. And you calibrate it. Everything is mixed and it is coming up here. So this is how you can create your pages and point of view. Now right now, how do you feel? For both the webforms, you are opening for only actuals and you are opening for targets. Say if you are having different actuals and different budget. If you can, here it will be displaying actuals and here it will be displaying budget. Combined things will be displayed. Okay? There is no such peculiar option enabling symmetric or unsymmetric. In whichever web form, if you find edit columns, analyze data forms. So, if I open this waveform, I'll say it is a symmetrical waveform looking at this column, columns and rows, because it is not having an edit column option. So, this is a symmetrical waveform. So, if I open this, a symmetrical waveform. So looking at this options itself, I can say this is an asymmetrical waveform. Yep. If you have this option, you can say this is an asymmetrical. Okay, now let us create a web form based out of your revenue database and combine your revenue and expense account into one composite web form. So I'll say create and select my revenue. But in revenue, you have only revenue 02 account and you have all other assets liabilities accounts. But this is not a source plan type. This is a target plan type. So I'll say revenue. So let us select accounts and let us select, if you see, you will be able to see 02, 03, 04, 05, 06. But out of all these accounts, you can input numbers only on account 02, even in your local network. Submit. Target option and here is effect one. And press save. So now my requirement is I want this revenue and I want this asymmetrical form to be combined into one composite form. So I'll say create composite form, say rev versus expense. Okay, go to rows. So I have my revenue form and I also have my asymmetric form. So now if I open this revenue form, this will open only for your account 02, remaining accounts are blocked. Why they are blocked? Because they are dynamically calculated numbers. So all your dynamically calculated numbers will not be opened in your web forms. By default, they will be blocked. Though in your revenue or in expense view, both of which they will be blocked because they are dynamically calculated numbers. Okay, fine. Now, if I open revenue versus expenses, this web form is opening from your expense database and this web form is opening from your revenue database. This way you can create composite. So why are composite webforms used? Means to have a single webform out of two databases, or to have a look between your actuals and budgets, or to have a look between your variances, or to have a look between your previous year actuals and the current year. We will be using composite webforms. Composite webforms means not only two, you can have more than two. You can have even 10 webforms combined into a single one. So this is about your webforms. So today we have clearly discussed how to convert your currency, input your exchange rates, and we have seen how to create your composite, asymmetric, symmetric platforms. So tomorrow we'll take budget into consideration and we'll do this activity, because this has many steps in it. So we'll try to do these steps again, taking budget into consideration. We'll create symmetric webform, we'll create asymmetric webform, we will also create a composite webform. We will also try to convert our data. We will try to input exchange rates and we will try to even convert our currency. Fine. That we will be doing tomorrow. So once we are done with this activity, data forms, mostly completely done. In data forms, we also have seen how to block particular columns. Single column you can block. Even row you can block. Pages or point of view you cannot block. Only rows and columns, you have asymmetrical rows and asymmetrical columns. Okay, so tomorrow we will also be looking into task lists, menus, smart lists, user variables, and all these managed properties, copy data, clear cell details, alias tables, reporting, view statistics. Okay. Day after tomorrow, we will be looking into your security. Once security is done, we can go into business rules and finally into your work. That will complete your plan. In between, I want to import this particular forms into Excel sheet. Okay. So for your Excel sheet to work, okay. So if I use SBase, till now we were using SBase. SBase is used to connect only to your SBase database. But if I want to connect to planning applications, I have to use Hyperion. But for your Hyperion to work, you need to start one more service called as Hyperion Provider Services. This is a service which should be always running. So this is the service which should be started. If your Hyperion Smart View should work, means Hyperion Provider Services web application should be running. Let me start this. Okay. Now with this, I want to connect to my, when I click on this, automatically connection provider service will open up. When I click on this red button, it will ask what you want to connect, whether you want to connect to SBase or planning or BI server. Any one server you can connect. So I wanted to connect to my SBase server. Already it is connected. If you want to connect it, right click on it and say add. So if you want to connect to SBase, you can provide your SBase details, or if you want to connect to planning, you can provide your planning details. I've connected to SBase. Server name, localhost, username, admin, password is password. So your local host is added. When I expand this local host, I will be able to see all my SBase applications. Same way, I want to connect to my Hyperion planning. So I will right click on Hyperion planning and I will say add. And here I have to provide my server name. My server name is Verma, because I already added local host. Now I am adding Verma. Under that, 830 is your port number and the remaining things are 100. So nothing will be changing. I'll say server node name. So server node name is Verma. Okay. So your Verma server is created. When I expand this, I'll be able to see all my planning applications. In this, I want to open my Asia currency application. So through Smart View, you can open your web forms. So expand this web forms, I'll be able to see actual folder, and in this I'll be able to see actuals. So let me open this particular actual web form. So double click on this. this particular webform starts opening up or open form. So your form will be opened into your extension. Directly from here you can lock and send into planning, which in turn will be locking and sending your data into your SBS database. You can select your pages and you will be able to see your point of view also. Actuals and FI12 are point of view, they cannot be changed. You can do each and every. So difference between your Excel add-in and smart view is, your Excel add-in can connect to only to SBS database, but your smart view can connect to SBase and as well as planning. From planning, what all you can see? You can see web forms, you can see smart list, you can see task list, and all you can see from your smart. So we'll be discussing about this also. So the extra service that you need to start is provider service. Say for example, if I stop this service, what happens? So if I say reset connection or disconnect, if I try to connect it back, it throws an error saying that connection cannot, the provider services is not working. So you need to retry or you have to go and start your provider. Until and unless your provider services is not up, your smart view will not work. Whereas with Excel add-in, you need not to start any service. It will work directly on your SBS server. Okay? This is the difference. Okay. So tomorrow we'll see in detail into this. We will start working on smart view and also we'll create a composite, symmetric and asymmetric webforms for budget. అర్థమైందా? రేపు మళ్ళీ చెప్తాను, టుమారో ఐ విల్ అగైన్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్, కొంచెం తెలుగులో చెప్తాను. రిలీజ్ ఆల్ యువర్ సర్వీసెస్ ఆర్ డౌన్. ఓకే, యూ హ్యావ్ టు డిసైడ్, యూజర్ విల్ బి డిసైడింగ్ వెదర్ బేస్డ్ ఆన్ యూజర్ రిక్వైర్మెంట్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు డిఫైన్ దట్ పర్టికులర్.